Torn up grass, shattered glass, and broken tree limbs still mark the spot where Colby Haithcock died this weekend. His family holding on to the things they loved the most about the 16-year-old.
His smile, always happy. The things he loves in life, deer hunting, four-wheel riding, and big diesel trucks.
North Carolina Highway Patrol troopers say the crash happened around 2:20 in the morning, just around this curve. The driver, 17-year-old Evan DeForge, is recovering in the hospital. He's charged with DWI, and troopers say more charges could be on the way. The boys were classmates at Providence Grove High School and carpooled there every day.
There's no ill will towards the other families involved because, unfortunately, as many conversations as you have with a child, he's 16 and he made his own decision.
The night of the crash, Colby's parents say the teens were staying at a friend's house down the road.
The kids were trying to rip the dash apart to get him out, you know. This young lady was holding his Evan's head and comforting him and holding Colby's hand, and you know, she said she was screaming at him to wake up.
Colby's stepdad, David Anderson, says he died on impact. But there's a silver lining for this grieving family.
Colby can't do good on his own anymore, you know.
His parents decided to donate Colby's corneas, bone marrow, skin, heart valves, and veins, helping countless others who may not have had a chance without him.
Colby will live on helping other people.
Anderson hopes Colby's story can have an even bigger impact to encourage teens to never get behind the wheel drunk.
Learn from this, you know, to not ever do this, not ever put themselves in a position to be affected by this.
And his message to their parents?
You're not going to control your teenager, not as much as you think you are. They're going to find ways to do the things that they want to do. Just talk to them, make them, you know, try to make them understand as much as you can a hard-headed teenager, right? Share the story.